Julianne? My name is Debbie. How do you do? Welcome to Kleinfeld. Hi.
Thank you.
And who's this handsome man?
I'm Evan.
My name is Julianne Scott Pollock, and I am here today to find a dress for my vow renewal, which will be on the first anniversary of our wedding.
Is the groom going to join us for the interview?
He is.
I am the husband.
Oh, the husband, okay.
I'm Evan Scott Pollock. I'm Julianne's husband. My plans are to take her on a private vow renewal, just the two of us, on our anniversary, on a beach somewhere.
So you're already married?
Yes.
We had a beautiful fairy tale wedding with a 25-person bridal party.
Wow.
We had the big church wedding, and it was perfect, but a lot of it was about giving our families a time to celebrate.
This time, it's just going to be for us.
How does the whole family feel about you doing this?
They don't know.
Oh, okay. Tell me what you're looking for in a dress.
Something very simple. Maybe not stark white.
It's definitely a wonderful thing that a bride chooses a dress that is all about her, whether it be a specific detail or a color.
The first time around, I needed that big over-the-top dress with lots of sparkle in it. This time, I'm looking for something that feels natural.
I want to see her in something just kind of flowing in the breeze on a beach somewhere.
Where would you like to be price-wise with the dress?
$2,000 or so.
So you want to cap it about the $2,000 point?
I'd say $3,000.
Okay. So I am going to bring in some dresses for you. I think in this case, being a destination vow renewal, we are definitely going to look for something very different from the first dress.
It feels odd to be shopping for wedding dress again. Sort of like, oh, I'm like cheating on the first dress or something.
She would like something a little bit more of who she is and who they are as a couple. Full lace, spaghetti strap.
What do you think?
One of my friends got an all lace wedding dress, and Evan said he thought she looked like a doily, so I'm not sure what he'll think of this one. Do you like it?
It's a little bit heavy. You know, it definitely hangs, it doesn't float. What do you like about it?
I think the lace, very natural feeling.
It's a little bit more organic feeling. Does it look a little like a doily?
Yeah. I mean, it looks lacy and heavy, and I might set my coffee cup on it, but.
This isn't the one.
Not at all what I see on a renewal day on a beach.
Different look, a little bit more glam. You know, this is attached to the dress. Blows in the wind.
Feels more traditional?
Yes, it does. Do you want him to see this one?
Show real quick, yeah,
okay.
Just to see what he thinks.
Okay.
What do you think?
I like it. I like the back, the way the straps cross in the back.
I feel older in it.
It is a little bit more mature, you're right.
This is not the playful, whimsical vow renewal dress. It's definitely a lot harder than we thought it would be.
So I think we should try this one. It doesn't have the color, but you know what? You have all this dimensional flower.
Yeah, this one feels really comfortable.
Very pretty. It's very pretty.
This dress is beautiful, but I kind of felt a little bit swallowed by it.
It's almost a little heavy looking up on top.
That was just, it looks a little more traditional.
After all the white designs, it's time for a change.
The less traditional, the better.
This is the Claire Pettibone.
Oh, that's pretty.
Isn't that sweet?
There's color, that would be great.
Okay, this is the dress with color.
Very different.
It is very different.
You could actually see your figure through the tulle.
So no.
Okay.
Wow. I like it.
Her whole face changes when she puts it on. It's beautiful. I love it.
Do you like it?
It's very nice. I love that one.
I love the color.
I think it looks beautiful with your skin tone and your hair coloring. I think it's beautiful.
I feel like this is what I'm supposed to be wearing. The color is perfect. Can't believe how something can feel so casual and yet still feel so special.
She looks amazing. I think it's everything I pictured, and I think more importantly than that, I think it's exactly what Julianne was looking for.
So, what do you think?
I think it's the one.
You think that this is the dress?
This is the vow renewal dress.
You look amazing. The dress looks almost as good as you. Looks gorgeous. I really like it.
Okay.
I think that Evan really does love the peach dress. I think he loves that little bit of color. I think that it really does suit his wife.
Ashley.
Hey. I'm Keisha.
Hi,
nice to meet you. Welcome to Kleinfeld. Hello, and you are
John.
My name is Ashley.
I live in Minneapolis. I just got engaged last week, and I asked my dad if he would help me decide what kind of wedding dress I'm going to be in. We haven't always gotten to spend a lot of time just us together. My parents were divorced when they were young. Now we communicate across state lines.
I think it's important for us to make an effort to get together. We have drifted a little bit apart.
He lives in Texas. I only get to see him 2 or 3 times a year.
Wow.
What do you think of this dress?
I like it. That looks nice.
I can't move my arms.
Yeah? I think it accentuates your figure well. It does look really nice, I think.
But I can't move, though.
I really like this dress. It's classic, it's simple, but Ashley had some challenges with it in terms of how it felt on her.
Ashley is quite surprised that he is so involved in this picking process. I want to help them reconnect. I want to bring them together.
I really liked my dad's pick, but I couldn't get over the sleeves. That dress had to go.
Anything grab you?
I saw one of the other brides who was here who had a polka dot dress on.
Uh-huh. I never in a million years would have gone to the polka dot dress. It was like a wild card. It's just a fun 50s party dress.
Since Dad loves the polka dots, Joan suggests a dress with the same silhouette.
No. We'll bring them in.
Actually, Joan gave them to me, so.
Which one would you want to try on? I'm trying to decide which one I least dislike.
Ashley wonders if the dress choosing might be best left to the experts.
Right now, the dad, I think, has overpicked. He doesn't know what he's picking. I don't know what he's picking, and Ashley doesn't know what he's picking.
Okay.
I think I may have the perfect dress for Ashley. It's a Pnina Tornai. And it's a little bit of her and a little bit of her dad. The problem is the dress is $2,000 over the budget.
I really like it. I think it's gorgeous.
Oh my God, I love it.
I know, this is really pretty. This is kind of what he's been looking for too, the more simple, elegant, simplistic look.
Yes, I told you that it was a little bit more, but I said it would probably be the one. You're crying?
This is really good. No, I'm not crying. No, I'm not.
Are you crying?
No, I'm not gonna cry. I'm not crying.
Here Ashley comes in the Pnina Tornai, and her dad is speechless.
What do you think of this one?
Yeah, you look great in that dress. You look really nice.
This is an amazing dress, Dad.
And she had a moment.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. You were crying. You totally were crying. Yes.
I think this last dress really makes her figure look good.
Okay.
This is the dress that Keisha wanted to put you in.
I know.
Oh,
right.
I really feel like a bride in this.
Is this the one?
This is my dress.
Yay! John, we did it. Oh, my God.
It's a little over budget, but the alterations and everything will be $6,300, which is $1,300 over our budget.
I think it's a little more than we were planning. Could put a challenge on our budget for other parts of her wedding. But it may be that the dress and how she feels and looks in it is more important than some other things that we could spend money on as well.
Daddy, get out your checkbook. I'm feeling very loved. And I can't wait for the father-daughter dance.
I can picture Ashley walking down the aisle in that dress. Makes me feel good that I'm able to spend the time and make her happy and create an opportunity for us to do things together.